Pilios, the Brigada Coordinator from Eusebio High School.
I'm Amelia Spidario, the Faculty Club President of Eusebio High School.
Ako po si Ginoong Nixie Parani, SPTA President ng Eusebio High School.
I'm Barangay Councilor Grace Santaana, SGC Chairman.
Ako si Apple Sendanya, isang EHS alumnus at kasalukuyang SK Kagawad ng Barangay Rosario.
Hi guys! Ako nga pala si Kainer Miguel. Isa po akong Eusebio High School alumnus at kasalukuyan pong SK Chairman dito sa Barangay Rosario.
I am Alexa May D. Abdon, SSU President of Eusebio High School.
Ako si John Chidosho, Advisor ng SSG o Supreme Student Government.
Ako po si John Cedric T. Curimau, CIC President of Eusebio High School.
I'm Rodel Timbresa, CIC Advisor from Eusebio High School.
Ako po si Princess Taya, isang rapper at vlogger. Ako po ay mag-aaral ng Eusebio High School.
Ako po si Lori Lane, isang vlogger, influencer at former member ng ML48.
Hi, I'm DJ Tonyo Loco from T-Radio.
Hi, I'm Aiko Chihara, caregiver at Suraso Group Home Kaugue.
Ako si Paola Angelica Tablapus, General Manager ng Garnia Structural and Technical Solutions.
Ako po si Frank A. Miranda, ang life-changing president ng Rotary Club of Pasig Sunrise.
Ako po si Ma'am Bernadette Umanya, Master Teacher 1 ng Eusebio High School. Sa ngalan ng aking head teacher, si Ma'am Rosana Arde Guzman.
Ako si Ma'am Yulbert B. Manubag, Guidance and ESP Department Coordinator.
Hi! Ako si Ellen B. Peralta, Head Teacher ng Mapre Department.
Hello! I'm Ma'am Beth Ramos Estera, Head Teacher of Matemato.
Ako si Annabel Maborang Escote, Head Teacher ng Science Department.
Ako si Evelyn Villarin, TAE Head Teacher.
Ako si Aida Rakit, Head Teacher ng Araling Panlipunan.
Ako po si Rafi Maga, Assistant to the Principal ng Senior High School.
Ako si Lenita Valiente Ranyon, Filipino Department Head Teacher. Halina, sumama at maki-EHS Brigada.
Halika na, sama na at maki-EHS Brigada.
Halika na, sumama 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 at maki-EHS Brigada.
Po si Annalyn Miranda Makasinag, principal ng Eusebio High School. Halika na, sama na at maki-AHS Brigada.
Hello mga kabrigada, umpisa na po ang ating pakikipagkapit-bisig sa ating paaralan. Ang ating pong paaralan ay muling inilalapit sa inyo ang maaari nating kailanganin sa paghahanda sa nalalapit nating pasukan. Upang tugunan natin ang ating mga pagsubok na kinakaharap sa panahon na ito ng pandemya. Kung kaya nga, inilunsad po natin ang proyektong Pak na Pak, pangangailangan at kalusugan na prioridad sa kabataan at kaguruan na pagtulong sa paaralan. Kami po ay naniniwala na ang pagtugon at pagtuon sa kaligtasan, kalusugan ay katugunan sa ikatutuloy na pag-aaral ng mga mag-aaral at kaguruan. Ito po ay kinakailangang bigyan ng prioridad. Ang proyektong Pak na Pak ay nakatuon sa Health and Information Drive, Safety and Health Assistance, Load and Internet Connection, Sanitations of Facilities, Education Assistance, and Volunteerism, especially in our Bulayan sa Paralan. Kaya tara na mga kapartners, tayo na makiisa sa ating EHS Brigada Eskwela.
tulungan. Walang kupas na kaugalian. Tatagatibay, sinasabuhay. Galak sa puso ay walang kapantay. Panahon na naman ang bigada. Pagbigisin, lakas at diwa.
Sabay-sabay, kapit-bisig, buong bayan. Tara na, kumilos na.
Tulong-tulong sa pagsulong. Hatid na kalidad sa edukasyon. Sa kabataan, saya at dunong. Buong madlas, sabay na aahong. Panahon na naman ng brigada. Pagbigisin lang diwa. Tara na brigada na.
Brigada, eskwela, magkaisa, sama-sama. Brigada, eskwela, salit na buong barkada. Brigada, eskwela, kilos na magbayanihan na. Brigada, eskwela.
Good morning, everyone. Ayan. So, napakaganda nung napanood natin kanina tungkol sa Brigada Eskwela. Ganun pa man, nais ko kayong bigyan ng mga ilang paalaala bago tayong magsimula ng ating webinar. Okay? So, ipa-flash natin ngayon yung mga dapat nating ipaalaala, yung ating netiquette all throughout our webinar. Okay? So, number one, be on time. And I can see most of you ay nandito na, no? Napakarami na nating attendance, and that's a good indication na everybody wants to listen and wants to learn something new today. Number two, dress appropriately. Alright? Number three, avoid eating or drinking. Kung hindi nyo ma-avoid na kailangan nyong kumain, please turn off your camera. Okay po? Number three, find clean and quiet space. And then number four. And number five, mute your microphone. I just want to give an emphasis dito, no? Gusto kong bigyan din itong number five natin. Always see to it na laging nakamute ang ating mga microphone. Naintindihan ko ba? Ulitin ko lang po, lalo na po sa mga magulang at sa mga estudyante ngayon na talagang eager na makinig at matuto ngayong webinar natin ngayon. Ulit ko lang po, always mute your microphone. If may mga questions kayo or anything na you want to clarify during our seminar or webinar, meron po tayong chat box na pwedeng gamitin. Tulad ng sinasabi sa number 6, only ask questions during the time of open forum. Number 7, avoid asking repeated questions. At ang mga questions po na dapat natin itanong ay tungkol sa ating pag-uusapan ngayong umaga ito. Ano po, may mga orientation tayo sa per level, so doon nyo po siguro itanong yung mga gusto nyo itanong. But please ask necessary or yung questions na napag-uusapan natin mamaya sa ating webinar. Number 8, be concise. And number 9, as I said earlier, put your questions in the chat box, and I, the host today, will read it for you. Okay? So alam ko naman po, familiar tayo sa netiquette na ito. Again, I just want to repeat and repeat and repeat once again yung ating number 5, 6, 678-9 na netiquette. Okay po? Maraming salamat po. In a few moments, mag-umpisa na po ang ating webinar and please have time to relax and sit in a comfortable chair para po sa ating webinar ngayon. Salamat! Okay, so siguro ang mga inaasahan nating mga attendees ngayong umaga na to yung mga estudyante, especially yung mga senior high school na yung mga bago sa ating school na ang dami nilang mga gustong malaman at matututunan. So this webinar is for you. So we will be also having question and answer sa ating forum mamaya sa ating pagkatapos ng ating speaker. So ang topic natin ngayon napakaganda lalong-lalo na sa ating lahat, no, lalo na sa mga nanay din, no, para magabayan natin yung ating mga anak tungkol sa pangangalaga ng kanilang mga mata. Ayan, nabigyan ko na kayo ng idea kung ano bang pag-uusapan natin ngayong umaga na ito. So again, ulitin ko lamang kung meron kayong mga questions or clarification sa mga bagay-bagay tungkol sa pag-uusapan natin sa pangangalaga ng mata, ilagay nyo lang yan sa ating chat box. And there are teams, meron tayong team na nagbabasa ng ating mga questions. May mga teachers tayo na nagmamasid sa lahat sa atin, lalo na sa mga estudyante na magiging pasaway mamaya. So we are expecting na walang pasaway sa taga Eusebio. Tama ba, mga taga Eusebio? Ayan. So ulitin po namin, ha, yung number 5, always mute your microphone. And then if you have question, put it in or write it in our chat box. Ulitin ko lamang, may mga teachers tayo o meron tayong team na magsasabi sa akin ng mga questions at may team tayo na magmamasid kung sino ang magiging pasaway na estudyante. But I believe and we believe, konti lang o walang pasaway na estudyante sa atin. Okay? So just stay there at maya-maya magsisimula na tayo. Okay? Alright, so I think we shall begin. Let me start this with this one. We live in a wonderful world that is full of beauty, charm, and adventure. There is no end to the adventures that we can have if only we seek them with our eyes open. So, yun po, let me repeat it once again so that it would give us some inspiration this morning. We live in a wonderful world that is full of beauty, charm, and adventure. There is no end to the adventure that we can have if we only seek them with our eyes open. To our dear school principal, Ma'am Annalyn M. Makasinag, assistant to the school principal, head teachers, master teachers, teachers, parents, students, and distinguished guests, good morning. My name is Jesse A. Catorce, and I'm your host today. To begin our webinar, let's have our audiovisual presentation of nationalistic song prepared to us by Ma'am Ashley Ramoso of English Department, which will then be followed by the prayer to be led by our chairman and program implementation of Brigada Escuela 2021, Ma'am Beralyn M. De La Cruz.
Mga kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Kayang mag-ibig, Diyos ng sinanganan, alam ng puso, sa dikit mo'y buhay.
Ama naming banal at makapangyarihan sa lahat, hari ng mga hari at Diyos na puno ng habag. Salamat po sa patuloy na pagkakaloob sa amin ng panibagong kalakasan at karunungan. Salamat po Ama sa presensya ng mga magulang, aming mga mag-aaral na nakasama sa umagang ito. Inisin niyo po ang aming puso sa lahat ng aming nagawang kasalanan. Dalangin po namin ang patuloy na gabay, lalo na sa panahon ng pandemya. Nilalapit po namin ang aming tagapagsalita sa umaga ito, si Dr. Fernandino Fontanilla. Gayon din po ang bawat isa na maging maayos ang koneksyon sa internet o sa data. Patuloy na kayo po ang muna sa aming punong guro, mga puno ng kagawaran, dalaguro, gayon din sa aking kapwa guro. Sa lahat ng ito ay aming itinataas ang pangalan ng aming Panginoong Hesus. Amen.
Sir, pwede na po? Sir Jesse?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Hello po. Magandang umaga sa lahat. Sa ating masipag na punong guro, Ma'am Aline Emma Kasinag. Sa ating assistant to the principal from Junior High School, Ma'am Net Ranyon. Sa mga head teachers natin, subject group head and subject group coordinators. Sa ating PTA President, Sir Parani, no, sa ating mga magulang, sa mga mag-aaral ng Eusebio High School, sa ating brigada team na talaga namang pinangatawanan ang trabaho, no, ngayong bago magpasukan, napakasipag nila, sa ating most especially to our brigada coordinator, Ma'am Gemma Rubilios, at sa ating bisita na magbibigay sa atin ng bagong kalaman na si Dr. Fernandino Montanilla, isang maganda at mapagpalang umaga sa lahat. Tayo ay nasa ikatlong araw na ng ating brigada webinar, at kung inyong mapapansin, iba-iba, no? Iba-iba ang kaparaanan kung paano natin ginagawa ang brigada eskwela sa taong ito. Iba lamang ng kaparaanan pero pareho pa din ang essence, sabi nga. Ito ay tumutukoy sa partisipasyon ng mga komunidad at pribadong sektor, pribadong tao upang maihanda hindi lamang ang pampublikong paaralan kundi pati na rin ang ating mag-aaral sa pagbubukas ng taong panruan. Ang ating magiging aktibidad ay nakatuon kung paano tayo makapagtulungan upang mabuhay ng ligtas at mabigyan ng lunas ang problemang pamparalan, tahanan at sa ating komunidad. Ang ating unang araw ay nakatuon sa stress management of the young minds. Ito ay di lamang nagbigay ng pagtuto sa ating mga mag-aaral, magulang at sa aming ding mga guro. At ang pangalawang araw naman ay nagbigay ng pagtuto sa mga guro kung paano gumamit ng Microsoft Outlook at bagong kalaman on COVID Delta virus. Ngayong araw ay nakatuon naman sa physical na aspeto ang ating mata. Ako lamang ba yung taong yung mata pagpagod na tumitibok, buti pa yung mata tumitibok, no? So yung parang pumipintig siya pagpagod na pagod at sa kakatingin sa laptop at cellphone. Ako lamang ba yung taong nalalabo yung mata? Ako lamang ba yung taong pag tumitingin sa laptop o sa cellphone, parang sumasakit? Pagising ko sa umaga, yung pag matagal na gumagamit, pagising ko sa umaga, masakit ang ulo ko, no? Ang mga katanungan yan ay marahil masasagot ng ating speaker ngayong araw. Kaya mga magulang, mga kapwa kuguro at mga lalas sa aming mag-aaral, makinig at matuto, isa puso at isa buhay ang inyong matututunan. Laging tandaan ang isang palasak na kataga, health is wealth, and prevention is better than cure. Muli po, magandang umaga at maraming salamat.
Yes, Sir Rafi, thank you so much for that warm welcome, and thank you also Sir Rafi for helping me recapping the past webinars. Ano po? But anyway, once again, Sir Rafi, our assistant to the school principal of Senior High School. Once again, let's give Sir Rafi a big round of virtual applause. Ayan. Thank you po. Busy yan si Sir Rafi. Mayroon pa siyang meeting, and thank you for taking your time po na mabigyan kami ngayon sa Brigada Eskwela ng inyong time. Maraming salamat, Sir Rafi, and God bless you, sir. Sa tingin ko kay lagi. As I said, gaya ng sinabi ni Sir Rafi, this is our third day of webinar, and nung mga nakaraang pong webinar ay napakaganda at patuloy na magiging magandang ating mga topic. Nung day 1 po, nagkaroon po tayo ng stress management at young minds na pinangunahan po ni Dr. Maria Nabal. Doon sa day 1 na yun, nakita ko ang stress ay hindi lang negative. Day 2, which is kahapon, yung diniscuss ng napaka-able na si ng ating ICT coordinator na si Ma'am Beatrice Villarin, yung Microsoft Outlook and OneDrive. Diniscuss ni Ma'am yung basic navigation at mga basic function ng Microsoft Outlook and OneDrive. And yesterday also, after that talk, pinakita rin, nagkaroon din tayo ng discussion with regards doon sa COVID Delta virus, no, na pinangunahan ni Dr. Laura Rhee Evangeline Perez Miranda. And we would like to take this opportunity also na kahit na binabagyo si Doktora, talagang ginagawa niya lahat ng paraan para mabigyan tayo ng serbisyo at maibahagi sa atin ang mga ilan pang kaalaman ng tungkol sa virus na ito, yung Delta virus. Totoo po, no, napakabilis ng pagkalat na ito ng Delta virus, hindi ito joke. And then again, ang sabi niya, the same pa rin ang mga precaution na dapat nating gawin. Pag-iingat, like yung maghugas ng kamay every now and then, wear mask, at mahalaga yung social distancing. At kung makakapagpabaksin po tayo, let's have ourselves be vaccinated. So today we are here to listen and learn on how to take care of our eyes. The widespread outbreak of COVID-19 has led to the adaptation of online teaching by most schools. All of them are now providing daily lectures with the help of online classes. Considering the entire situation and the status of the online classes, we can say there are many pros and cons of online learning. Eye strain is one of the disadvantages of online classes, and it is not possible to avoid it completely. With this kind of situation, the whole team of Brigada Eskwela 2021, led by Ma'am Berylyn M. De La Cruz, initiated this kind of topic of our webinar today to reduce eye strain due to online classes or studies. It is a great pleasure for me to introduce our speaker today. Our speaker has had a distinguished career as an eye doctor. He is a doctor of medicine at the University of the Philippines College of Medicine, residency in Ophthalmology Philippines General Hospital, Ocular Immunology Fellowship, University of Illinois at Chicago, Master's in Business Administration, Ateneo Graduate School of Business, Dean and Professor at College of Medicine, San Beda University, Member, Board of Directors, Asian Hospital, Head, UBIT Service, the Medical City Pasig, Member of CPD Council for Medicine, Philippine Regulation Commission. Practicing ophthalmologist at Asian Hospital and Medical Center, the Medical City Pasig, and the Medical City Southern Luzon. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dr. Fernandino Jose A. Fontanilla. Let's give him a virtual round of applause. Take it away, Doctor.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. No? Magandang umaga. I hope everyone's staying safe, no? So kagaya na banggit kanina, no? The COVID is really still a problem for us right now, no? But hopefully we can have a relaxed atmosphere this morning as I try to talk to you about our eyes, no? And let me just begin that by sharing my screen. Okay. Can you all see my screen?
Yes, po. Nakikita na po na.
Okay. So, good morning. Our talk today is about... it's okay. I can talk in Tagalog. Kung gusto yung Tagalogin ko yung buong talk, pwede rin naman.
Opo. Okay lang po. May doc, meron po tayong mga magulang, estudyante po na nakikinig po sa atin. Okay lang po. Salamat po.
So, English is okay? Or Tagalogin ko na lang?
English and Tagalog pa will do. Opa, salamat po.
I'll do it na lang in English. Anyway, mas para mas mabilis. Anyway, so our topic for today is about preserving good vision. It, essentially, how we can take care of our eyes. And I chose this picture of a child, no? It's important, no, that I like to stress out, especially we're in the field of education, that vision begins early on, no, from the time we are born. So we cannot just... ignore our eyesight, no, and just worry about it in our later years. So as early childhood children who are even as young as 4 years old, they should already have their eyes checked or examined. So our agenda for today is, first, I'd like to just discuss some misconceptions about our vision, no, and then we will talk about some common eye symptoms, no, the common causes of blindness worldwide, no. But probably focus more on the common eye conditions that we are currently experiencing, no? Especially with online learning, and what we can do to protect our vision. What are these misconceptions? So we always say health is wealth, na pinangangalagaan natin yung ating kalusugan. However, we always forget about the eye because we don't encounter any problems. We don't think that there's any issue. So we don't even have our eyes examined. So that's one misconception, no? That
ayan.
Hello po, paki-mute lang po. Sorry, Doc. Please mute po natin ang microphone. Salamat po. Doc? Hello, Doctor? Ayan. So, I think...
Okay, sorry. Yeah. I'm sorry. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So, okay na. So, the second misconception is that glasses is the solution to all eye problems. That's not always true, no? And so people like to go to the optical shops, papasukat ng salamin, no? Sige, baka kasi yun daw ang dahilan. But sometimes it's not a simple solution, no? As these patients will need something more. The other thing is that wearing glasses will make you dependent on them. Kaya may mga pasyente tayo, ayaw na magsuot ng salamin kasi pag nagsuot daw, tuloy-tuloy na magsasalamin. That's also a misconception.
Hi, Doc. Kamusta po? Ah, Doc, yeah. Sorry to interrupt you po. Parang hindi po na nagagalaw po yung slide. Tama po ba?
I'm still on the first page ba?
Ah, yes po. Nasa first page pa rin.
Okay. Wait.
I think nasa third slide na po. Kayo ngayon.
There. Misconceptions.
Apo.
Okay. Okay siya. Can you see this one now? Misconceptions?
Not yet po, Doc. Nasa first slide pa rin po.
Ah, okay. It's not...
Nah.
Yeah. I'll just... hold on, ha? Let me just. I'll just do it this way. Para mas sigurado yan. Can you see? That's the first slide, correct?
Yes, po. Correct po.
Okay. And then, if it's okay, you know, we'll just...
yeah, click doon po yung...
Yeah, click. Yung yeah, ganyan na lang. Ayaw niya gumana doon sa ano eh. Okay.
Sige po.
So, this is our agenda for today, no? We'll talk about the misconceptions about our vision, common eye symptoms, the common causes of blindness worldwide. Then we'll probably discuss more on common eye conditions and eye diseases and how we can protect our eyes. So what are these misconceptions? So we always say that the health is wealth, no? So we try and tend to focus on other things, but we always forget about our eyesight, no? Maybe because we don't experience anything and we don't go for an eye checkup. If ever we go for an eye checkup, we actually go to an optical shop, no? Sa mall. Most people believe that just with the use of glasses, they're okay, that they can solve all eye problems, no? There's also another misconception when we prescribe glasses to patients, ayaw nila. They say, oh, eh, pag nagsuot na ako salamin, tuloy-tuloy na yan. So they don't like to wear glasses, no? That's also not true. Common misconception, my mom used to tell me this, na masama magbasa pag dilim, no? Reading in the dark is bad for eyes. Not really, but it can cause eye strain, but it's not really harmful. Some patients actually, or some people really don't like using bright light, no? And then you have to just choose the amount of light enough for you to see well. Another misconception is that eye drops can cure all eye problems. Only some, not all, no? And so some patients are led to believe that they're okay just because they're using some eye drop that was prescribed to them by maybe the drugstore or their neighbor who advised them to use this eye drop, when in fact something worse is actually happening, no? So that's not also good. And lastly, we believe that blurring of vision and poor eyesight is a problem primarily of older patients or older people. That's also not true, no? We encounter a lot of eye problems even in the younger age group, even in kids who are still in grade school, no? The working class people in their 20s, 30s, okay? So let's now talk about what the common symptoms are. I think most of you are familiar with this, no? Our common symptoms include redness, namumulay mata, no? Masakit yung mata. Of course, palabo yung mata, no? May pagmumuta or nagluluha, no? Tearing and eye discharge. Or occasionally we have patients who tell us there's something na gumagapang daw sa harap ng paningin nila, floaters, no? So, what are the common causes of blindness? We'll talk about the common causes of blindness first before we talk about common eye conditions that will probably be more appropriate for the audience we have today. So, it's been reported that common causes of blindness worldwide include 1, cataract, no? 2, glaucoma, and 3, diabetic retinopathy, particularly in our country where we have a very high incidence of diabetes, no? So, let's talk about cataracts first. Okay, so what is cataract? No, it is the whitening or opacification of the human lens. So our eye has a human lens inside. No, it's a clear lens. No, just like a camera. A camera will not be able to take nice pictures without the lens. No, the image will be blurred. So our eye, we like to compare it to a camera where you actually also have a lens. No. So yung lens na yan, clear, parang salamin. But as we get older, there can be whitening or opacification as shown in the photos. No? So the photos you see there are photos of patients with cataracts. Yes, it is common in the older age group. No, we usually say that patients in their late 50s, 60s can start developing cataract. And it is a progressive condition, meaning as you get older or as the years go by, the whitening will just increase. However, cataracts can also be seen in the younger age group. So hindi lang naman yan sa matatanda. You can also see that in young patients, no, from time to time. And usually you see this in patients who have diabetes. So I have one patient before. She was only 39 when I diagnosed with her cataract. I was wondering why she had a cataract. She also didn't know. We did a check on her sugars and she has diabetic. And that was probably the cause of her cataract. Another common cause is the use of steroid eye drops. No, we have patients who use steroids probably because it helps relieve the allergies in the eye. No, or they use steroids for asthma. No, whether nasal steroids or oral steroids. Although they are beneficial to other diseases, also in the eye, it's also used for allergic problems of the eye. Overuse of steroids or excessive amounts of steroids can also cause cataract. And there are other conditions in the eye, no? Primarily the inflammatory eye diseases, which I will not discuss, but this can also lead to cataracts. So what are the common complaints of patients with cataracts? One is a cloudy vision, no? And the other one's a foggy vision, parang may ulap, no? Or parang may nakaharang, no? So cataracts in general are not managed with eye drops, no? So we do encounter patients who occasionally use eye drops prescribed by either their primary physician or probably recommended by a friend or a neighbor. It will not stop the cataract. The cataract will still progress, and at some point the vision will be so bad, no? And the only true treatment for cataract is surgical removal, no, and replacement. I will not discuss that today, just for your information that cataracts, when they are severe, they will need to be operated on. The other common cause of blindness is glaucoma. So what is glaucoma? No, it is an eye condition where there is damage to the optic nerve. So the optic nerve, that's the one that connects the eye to the brain, no? It sends the signal to the brain. So the optic nerve, because usually of high pressures inside the eye, no? So if we have high blood pressure in the body, sa mata naman, it's high pressure of the eye or intraocular pressure. That can damage the optic nerve, no? Again, it is probably more common in the older age group, no? Primarily in those above the age of 60. And the problem here is that it is usually detected late in most patients because usually there is no symptom. What patients don't realize is that there is actually a loss of peripheral vision. So if you'll see the photograph here, you can still see the boat, no, the ship, no, but the peripheral vision is gradually diminishing, no, and central vision, the vision in the middle, yung, is always preserved until the very end, and that's why these patients come in too late because they see well in the middle, not realizing peripheral vision is being lost gradually over time. Occasionally, you may encounter patients who also have eye pain, complaints of eye pain and eye redness. And these are the patients who will come into your clinic, no? And usually it's because the pressures are really high. Hopefully, the vision isn't still severely compromised, no? So management of glaucoma depends on the stage. We'd like to get them early on when the glaucoma is just beginning. So we really strongly advise that they get screened or they have regular eye checkups because in early stages, you know, you can just manage glaucoma with topical eye drops, no? Glaucoma eye drops or anti-glaucoma eye drops. It is only in the late stages, no, where the vision is severely compromised, talagang malabo na or the pressures hindi na talaga namin makontrol, no? That is the only time you will probably have to do surgery or some other intervention. So again, early diagnosis and early management is the key. The third most common cause of blindness worldwide is diabetic retinopathy. So again, no, it's usually seen in diabetic patients with very high blood sugars, elevated blood sugars. No, this one hits all ages, even in the Philippines. We are seeing diabetic patients as young as in their 20s or 30s. Probably because of lifestyle, especially nowadays, we're mostly online. Wala na tayong exercise, no? Nakaupo lang tayo parati sa app ng computers. Our diet, no? In the Philippines, our diet is mainly rice, no? So we have high carbohydrate levels in our diet, which is not good, and will really push you towards diabetes, no? And the main problem here is that there is damage to the blood vessels in the retina. The retina is the lining inside the eye, no? If we say that the lens of the human eye is similar to the lens of a camera, the retina is similar to, well, back then, during my time, the film of a camera. Ngayon, wala nang film yung cameras, di ba? Ano na sila? CMOS sensors, no? But that is the same, no? That's equivalent to the retina. That is where the image is formed, no? And if that is damaged, if the blood vessels are damaged, that will damage your vision. I don't know if you've seen photographs in the past where there is a damaged portion, maybe because of the negative or the film was also damaged. No? So what will the patient experience? Oh, it's varied. They can complain of, initially in the early stages, there's usually no effect yet, but they can also complain of decreased vision. No, distortion of vision. No, so if you look at the photograph, same photograph as the photograph I showed earlier, but if you look at the mass of the ship, no, it is curvy, it is wavy because there's already some distortion of vision. They can also complain of floaters. No, so if you'll see these gray lines here on top, no, yeah, and these can be floaters that are moving about. No? Sometimes they may indicate blood clots floating in the view of the patient. No. So that's what we call floaters. And lastly, it can be a huge, no, a huge blockage, something that's really blocking their vision. No. So how do you manage this? Well, again, screening is very important. So nowadays, all patients who are diabetics are recommended to have an eye exam at least once. No. So we can determine if there's already some damage occurring in the retina. And then after that, they can just have regular follow-ups. Depending on what we see, management can be nothing, just continue with the diabetic management, the medications for diabetes, or maybe laser, or maybe surgery. No, but we hope we can get them early so they can be managed conservatively. So after I've discussed the top three causes of blindness in the world, let's now discuss the more common conditions that we can encounter. No? So the first is error of refraction. No? I see some of you, no, I'm looking at your pictures. No, some of you are wearing glasses. That means you have an error of refraction. So what is an error of refraction? Refractive errors means that the shape of your eye, it's not perfect enough to bend the light correctly so that it will focus on the retina. So in the top picture here, no, where there's normal vision, all the light rays upon entering the eye is focused directly on the retina. So you have a clear image. Just like a camera, you need to focus it. No? Now, if the eye is unable to do so, then it will create a refractive error. If it focuses in front of the retina, like in the right upper photo, then that is called nearsightedness or myopia. If it focuses behind the eye, like in the lower left photo, that is called hyperopia or farsighted. No? Presbyopia is a different condition. You are just unable to focus for near. No, usually we see this in individuals who are 40 years old and above. And astigmatism means it's a mixture of far and nearsightedness. No? As you can see on the right lower photo, the image is focused at different levels. Okay. This is actually something to do with the shape and size of the eye. So a patient who has no refractive error means that their eye is perfectly spherical in shape such that all the light rays are focused on the retina. So how do we correct that? No, it's simple. No, for those of you already wearing glasses, well, that's the real way of managing refractive errors, or the simplest way of managing refractive errors. No. You may have glasses for farsightedness, nearsightedness, some of them with a combination of astigmatism. For those above the age of 40 who have presbyopia, you need reading glasses. Others who have very high grades may resort to contact lenses. So rather than having the lens in an eyeglass frame, you have the lens right there on the surface of the eye. So that's a contact lens. No? Contact lenses, just as an additional advice, no? That's very safe to use if you will clean it regularly and not use it for more than 8 hours. Now, for those of you wearing contact lenses, we advise that you limit the use, no, maximum of 8, maybe 10 hours, clean it daily, and the minute you sense it's causing irritation, you dispose of those contact lenses. There might be damage or bacteria in it, and you don't want complications arising from damage or dirty contact lenses. The newest way of managing error of refraction is through LASIK. Ito yung tinatawag nating laser, no? Actually, there's so many kinds, no? We just call it laser surgery, but there's actually LASIK. There's also actually PRK and the new one, which is the SMILE. No? But they're just variations of laser technology. Essentially, it's designed to reshape the surface of your eye so that your the surface of the eye or the cornea can now refocus all the light rays entering the eye back onto the retina. Okay. So maybe some of you have had already LASIK treatment. The only downside to this, it's expensive, although the prices have gone down over the last several years. No? And it's only available in big eye centers and hospitals. The last is what we call ICL or intraocular columnar lens. No, this is the one of the newer modalities. No, essentially, we rather than having a contact lens on the surface of your eye, we place it inside the eye. So it works very well, especially for those who have really, really high grade, no? High grade naman, 900, 700, kanya. Well, disadvantage, one, it's expensive also. Two, requires surgery, no? It's a minor surgery, probably 10, 15 minutes only, but it still is surgery, meaning that we will have to enter the eye, no? So ito na, let's go now to digital eye strain. I think this is the topic that you are more concerned about, no? So, as mentioned earlier, we are mostly online now, no? Maybe 8 to 5 pa nga for some of you, or even more. You still have to do your, for the students doing their homework and assignments, for the teachers doing your lectures for the next day. So what is digital eye strain? It is a group of eye and vision related problems. So it's not one particular disease. It's just a bunch of complaints, no, that we lump under digital eye strain, and it is related to prolonged gadget use, no. So what are the common complaints? You can have eye discomfort, no, dryness, no, irritation. It can also lead to some blurring of vision. For some, they experience tearing of the eyes. And if it's really severe, you can actually have headaches. No? Using devices will not really damage the eye. It will not cause permanent damage, no? But it can cause these symptoms. And that is what we call digital eye strain. So what can we do with digital eye strain? I'd like to divide this into four areas. One is actually proper posture. Number two, proper setting on your devices. Number three, you have to have the proper environment. And you also have to have proper use of the devices. So let's talk about posture. So first of all, you have to make sure that your computer, no, or your laptop is at eye level. No? It's not good for you to have your laptop down, no, and you're actually looking down. You're tilting your neck this way. Why? Because you will actually strain the neck muscles at the back, and that can cause eventually some strain. As you're continuing on with your online classes or your use of digital devices, no? So I don't know if some of you are already using this device that keeps the laptop up, no, to bring it to eye level, no? My son, we also have that for his laptop. So now he doesn't have to bend his neck forward, no? You can see the screen head on, no? Without you having to reposition your head and your neck is straight. No? Another thing is that you have to keep the device, the screen, at a proper distance. It cannot be too close to you. Otherwise, it will cause eye strain. So it should be roughly around 2 feet away, or maybe 18 to 24 inches away from the eye. So that's the proper distance. No? Proper setting on the devices. Well, one, make sure that you have the right size of font also. No, no matter how you position the device well and maintain it at the proper distance. If the fonts are too small, then you will really have difficulty seeing it. So you really have to adjust the font. No, if possible, it would be really nice to use a big screen. No, so right now, although I have laptops, I'm also using a big monitor. No, so that I can see things better. It doesn't cause strain on the eye. Adjust the brightness as well. There's no particular level. It's the level that your eye is comfortable. It shouldn't be too bright. It shouldn't be also too dark. No, just enough so that you have the right contrast and you see the images and the words well. No? And then proper environment. So by proper environment, what we mean here is that avoid direct wind. No, which is directed directly into the eye, no, or facing your eye. For example, your electric fans, no. I know mainit, we want to stay cool as we're doing our online work, and we tend to face it in front of us, facing us. What will that do? It will cause dryness of the surface of the eye, no. And when that happens, you will experience the symptoms of irritation, dryness. And I will discuss more about dryness because that is a separate topic by itself in the latter part of my talk today. And also about the use of lubricant drops, no? So proper use of devices, no? Again, we have this 20-20 rule, no? That after every 20 minutes, you take a break for about 20 seconds, no? Don't look at the screen, look at something else. And look at something 20 feet away. You want to relax the muscles of the eye, because as you're looking at something close to this to you, no, like 18 to 24 inches, your muscles in the eye are contracting. No, you need to relax that. Kailangan makahinga naman siya. Imagine if you're holding a book ganito. Yung punishment ng bata kami, hawak kami book ng ganyan 1 hour, di ba? Di ba mga ngawit? Eh, the eye is the same thing. May muscles din yan sa loob ng mata, so it will also develop strain. And also blink regularly, no? Blink a lot. The problem when you're reading something or looking at something, the blink rate, yung dalas ng pag-blink ng mata is decreased. So what you want to do is blink so that you can recoat the surface of your eye to avoid the dryness, no? So because we're talking about blue light, about the use of computer monitors, let's now talk about blue light, because this is another hot topic that came out last year. So what is blue light? Sunlight is actually made of a spectrum of visible light, no, from the blue range, which you see in the screen, no, all the way to the red. And eventually there is an invisible range already, no, the ultraviolet, no, and the infrared, no. So, but this is visible light, blue, light blue, the green, yellow, and the red, no. So blue light is on the lower spectrum, no. It is actually needed for good health, no. With blue light, we boost our alertness, helps with our memory, our cognitive function, and elevates mood, no. So during the daytime, blue light is actually is good, no, because it's during the daytime where we're more active. It also is involved in regulating the what we call the circadian rhythm, the body's normal sleep wake cycle. So siya yung signal to wake up, sharing, if you take that out, then that is the signal to sleep, no. So blue light is actually also beneficial. And like I said, no, the sources of blue light, the larger source is the sunlight, no. It you can also get this from fluorescent lamps, no, the compact fluorescent lamps, even LED light, no, our LED monitors, our LED TVs, most of our devices are LED now, no. They all have some amount of blue light. However, blue light is not aside from the sun, no, the sources of blue light from all of our devices now is not that much. So, what are the myths and truths about blue light? So one, there's the saying that blue light from screens will harm the eye. So that's a myth. The amount of light produced by these screens, no, is not enough to really cause eye damage. No? Of course, if you're using it 24 hours a day nonstop, then maybe. Okay. Blue light can cause digital eye strain. That's another myth. It is actually how we use our devices and not the blue light that causes the digital eye strain. Overuse is the problem. Anti-blue light glasses improve sleep. Actually, sleep can be improved by decreasing screen time. There's really no need for the eyeglasses. And I don't think you want to sleep with your eyeglasses on. No? So blue light is helpful during the daytime, and you have to withdraw it for you to be able to sleep well. So what you need to do is stop using your devices at night. No? That way, you can now induce sleep. If you use anti-blue light glasses during the daytime, then it blocks out the blue light, which I mentioned earlier, helps with alertness, cognitive function, memory. So that's the last myth. Anti-blue light glasses improve health. Well, they have not been really proven to help, no. And as I mentioned, no, blue light is actually beneficial. So maybe using them might decrease your alertness, your cognitive function, and your memory. So what are the recommendations of our society, the Philippine Academy of Ophthalmology, and as well as the Philippine Society of Pediatric Ophthalmology and Strabismus, which is a subspecialty society of the Academy of Ophthalmology, and particularly with the students, no, limit amount of screen time. So for my son in his school, their modules are only 40 minutes and they're given a 20-minute break. So they only have 4 modules in the morning. So 4 sessions of 40 minutes. After that, they are no longer online. No, they sign off before they sign into the next class. And they have 20 minutes to do whatever, read the book, take a break. So this is what we're saying. No, you have to limit the screen time. And well, ideally, the 20-minute rule is what we want. But if it's not possible, at least after 40 minutes, you can take a break, look at something else, and look away from the screen. Decrease your screen time at night. Again, mahirap gawin, di ba? Because we, for the students, marami tayong tinatrabaho sa gabi. We, and now it's online for faculty, for teachers, no? We still have to do some additional work at the end of the day, no? And sometimes it extends to nighttime and it's mostly online. But if you can, no? Once you're done, stop, no? Put aside na your smartphones, your iPads. I know, minsan may mga paggabi nandun pa sa devices, nag-Facebook, nag-YouTube, no? Nag-Netflix. If you want to sleep, you have to decrease that. Okay? If you, the more you trigger your brain at night, the more you will have difficulty sleeping. No? Once I go past a certain time, 10 ng gabi, and unfortunately, I still have to be online or I have to finish something on my devices, I already have difficulty sleeping. And maybe some of you are experiencing the same things. No? So try to develop a healthy habit. Try to finish all your device use early on so that you have time to slowly settle in before you get to sleep. Sleep is very important. As mentioned earlier, no, take frequent breaks from your screens, the 20-20-minute rule. Every 20 minutes, take a 20-second break and look at something 20 feet away. Decrease the brightness of your screen. So like I said, no, just adjust the right amount of brightness so that your eyes are comfortable and you see well. No? So like the myth before na pag nag-aaral ka sa madilim or nagbabasa sa madilim, masama sa mata. Actually, no. What's important is you just have the right amount of light so that you can see well. Too much light is also not too good. No? Also, increase your physical activity. Again, the 20-20-minute rule. You cannot be seated down all the time. No? That's not good for you. You need to allow circulation into your legs. No? For the older people, no, it's very dangerous if you sit down for too long because you can develop deep vein thrombosis. Even in the airplane, no, when you ride on long trips, we recommend that you walk the aisle because you need to keep the circulation growing in your legs. So screen time for kids. So what are the recommended screen time? Again, this was developed by our society. Of course, those below the age of 1 or 1 year and below, no screen time. They shouldn't be on devices to begin with. No, sometimes ganun kasing ginagawa. No? We give the device para maaliw yung bata. But no, that's not good. No, they should be more active but not on devices. Maybe for a 2-year-old, limit to no more than 1 hour. Actually, if you can avoid devices for them, that would be good. So again, it's easier for us. We just put them in front of the TV. They're watching something. No? The kids are quiet. The toddlers are quiet. But it's not really good for them, no, and for their eyes. No? 3 to 4 years old, again, just limit and encourage more physical activity. Above 5 years old, now, of course, because we are online, that is an issue. We would like to limit screen time. No, it should be guided screen time with frequent breaks. No, like I said, no, in the grade school, my son, it's modules of 40 minutes. In the medical school, no, where I teach, we recommend only 20 to 40 minute sessions. So the 1 hour face-to-face classes before were dropped down to 20 to 40 minutes. The faculty are now advised to decrease the online lecture and then just give more asynchronous work, no? Maybe reading textbooks or something like that. No? So go to the next. Being online, as I mentioned earlier, leads us now to problems of dry eyes. No? Dry eye is a common condition where there is inadequate lubrication of the surface of the eye, yung cornea natin. No? So because of this, usually you experience irritation, no, some burning sensation, no? And there are various symptoms that I will discuss in the next slide. Essentially, the tears are inadequate to provide proper lubrication of the surface of the eye. And this is due to many reasons, no? Which I will also discuss next. Okay, so what are the symptoms of dry eyes? No? More common is probably yung stinging, burning sensation. Sa Tagalog, mapde. Mapde yung mata ko. Yeah. And sometimes you may develop a discharge, no? Parang may muta. But the discharge is not purulent. Hindi siya parang nana or parang may infection. It's more of a stringy white discharge, no? Parang sipon. Okay? When the dryness involves the surface of the eye, the cornea, then there's sensitivity to light. No, looking at bright light, parang masakit, no? So you don't want to look at bright light. And you can also develop eye redness, no? For some, like me, I also have dry eyes. My symptom is actually foreign body sensation. Parang may buhangin sa mata. No? You can develop tearing. Actually, right now, this eye is tearing. My right eye is tearing, no? Because I've been looking at the screen for quite a while. And I'm in an air-conditioned room as well. Severe dry eyes can cause blurring of vision, no? And heaviness of the eyelid. So I don't know if you've experienced that na after being online for quite a while, parang inaantok kayo para mabigat yung eyelid. Actually, it might be just a symptom of dry eyes, no? The eyelids are sticky. Excuse me. So how do we manage dry eyes, no? The most common is the use of topical lubricants, no? There's a lot, no? So I just took this photo kanina. I grabbed whatever eye drops I had there, took a photo, but I don't use any particular eye drop and I do not prefer any particular one. I think most of them are good. It just depends on what the patient prefers, no? Some prefer one over the other, no? Because they feel more comfortable using those eye drops. So, and there's, these are not the only ones. There are even more eye drops available on the market nowadays. Demand for topical eye drops has increased mainly because we have also increased online time, no? Online, we have been doing a lot of online work, especially during the pandemic. What else can we do? We can modify the working environment. So like I mentioned earlier, no? We work sometimes in an environment where it's hot, so we have to use an electric fan or an air conditioner. But don't let it blow directly into your eyes. That will make your dryness worse, no? Direct it away from you. What you need is to just ventilate the room, no? Get an air circulation going, but not directly into your eye because that will enhance or increase the dryness. Nutritional support can also be helpful. There are some studies that show that the use of omega-3 fatty acids helps with the stability of your tears, no, on the surface of the eye. Sources of omega-3 fatty acids include seafood like salmon, no, fish oils, nuts, no. These are helpful. And lastly, if you're very symptomatic, we suggest you see an eye doctor, no? Because we have to do some tests to determine what exactly is happening. Dry eye, although I may make it appear simple here by just saying that it's decreased wetness or lubrication of the surface of the eye, there are many other things that can cause it, no? And we have to figure out what's really going on so that we can institute the proper management. Sometimes there is a very low-grade infection on the eyelids that you may not notice, and that is what's causing the dryness. Also, there might just be decreased production of the tears, and there are ways to work around that. No? As you see in the right lower photo, there is now actually a new technology called the IPL. No? It's a laser system that you can deliver to the eyelids to enhance the production of your tear component, no? To reduce the dryness. I actually had the treatment already done on me. I had really bad dry eyes a few years back. Now it's not so bad, but I think I want to already have a retreatment to enhance again the lubrication of my eye. So I'm actually on my last slide. How can we actually protect the eye? No? One is eat healthy. No? As I mentioned earlier, no, for dry eyes, they say that omega-3 fatty acids are helpful. So salmon is a good source, although it's an expensive fish, you know, but it's very good, very healthy source of fatty acids. You know, eat a lot of the vegetables, the high-value food groups, you know, and limit your intake of carbohydrates like rice and bread, you know, and limit the drinking soda. Very popular sa atin, drinking soft drinks or soda. Try to limit that. You know? I don't drink soda anymore, rarely, maybe once or twice a year if there's nothing else I can drink. So eat healthy, avoid high sugars, so avoid diabetes, which can lead to problems in the eye. Exercise well, no? I know we're online. We've decreased our activity. More so, we should be more conscious about our physical activity. You can do light exercises even in the comforts of your home. No, you can do calisthenics, stretching exercises. No, simple things just to get the circulation going. Okay, and that will help in terms of not just the general well-being of the body, but also helping preserve your the vision in your eye. Avoid smoking. I don't know how many of you are smokers, but I really advise you to avoid smoking. Smoking has a lot of detrimental effects to the eye. It has been suggested to cause one of the causes of cataract, one of the causes of macular degeneration. Just recently, I had a patient who has severe macular degeneration, almost no vision on one eye, and was a very hard smoker in the past. No? So you may not experience any problems with smoking now, and probably you all only enjoy the beneficial effects that it probably gives you, but that's just for now. The problems will come in later on. Okay. Be aware of your family history. So glaucoma, for one, can run in families. So if you have a family member who has glaucoma, we suggest that you also have your eye examined because you may actually also have glaucoma. Same with diabetes. Not diabetes, although most Filipinos have a tendency towards diabetes, if you have somebody who's already a diabetic, like your parents, you may want to also have your eye screened. No? There are other conditions in the eye also which are hereditary. And that's why if you have any family member with poor vision or history of poor vision, you may want to have an eye exam. And to do so, you don't go to an optical shop. The optical shops are good for making your glasses. But if you really want an eye exam, you go to an ophthalmologist, you know, who can do what we call a dilated eye exam, because it's the only way you can see the retina. So that's where we can pick up if there are any problems in the eye. For our current online work, which all of us are doing right now, lubricate your eyes well. No? These are actually over-the-counter eye drops, so you can just go to your drugstore, Mercury, or whatever pharmacy is near you, and ask for lubricant drops. No, most of them work, different formulations, no, but they are all effective. IMO is okay, but IMO is more of water. No, the lubricants that are really designed for the eye are more viscous, mas malapot, and they tend to stick to the surface of your eye better. And lastly, use protective glasses. No, I know some of you might be using the blue light glasses. Like I discussed earlier, there's really no benefit to it. But when I say protective glasses, these are protective glasses if you're outdoors. For example, protecting yourself from ultraviolet light. So ultraviolet light is harmful to the eye. No, it can also lead to cataract. It can also lead to macular degeneration. No, it can also lead to pterygium. No, yung pugita. So when you're outdoors, protect yourself from the harmful ultraviolet light of the sunlight. Ultraviolet light is not visible to the eye, but it is there. It's also actually harmful to the skin, and that's why you want to use sunblocks. No, but to the eyes, you can use protective glasses. Use sunglasses that have UV protection. No? So be careful lang, because there are also some people selling UV protection glasses, sunglasses. They claim are UV protecting, but we don't really know. For more information, because I just highlighted the more common conditions, common diseases, but there's a lot more out there. No, you can just visit our Facebook page, iCare.pao. This is the website, actually the Facebook page of our society, the Philippine Academy of Ophthalmology, the mother society of all eye doctors in the Philippines. There's a lot of information there about other common eye diseases, including migraine, eye strain, uveitis, no, diabetic retinopathy. So very helpful if you want to read more on these conditions. With that, I'd like to say thank you to everyone for listening. No, and I hope you learned something new today. And I'm open to questions if there are any. Thank you.
Yes, thank you so much, Dr. Fontanilla. Let's give Dr. Fontanilla a big round of applause, virtual lang round of applause. Maraming salamat po. Alam niyo po, Doc, actually, beforehand, kanina, marami nang nagpo-post ng mga questions. But yung pa-end na kayo ng talk ninyo para sinasabi dito, halos nasagot na ata ni Doc yung mga tanong namin. But we will be asking a little more of your time to entertain sure. questions. Uh-huh. Would that be okay, Doc?
Yes,
okay,
actually, that's why I didn't talk too much yung... because I wanted to give more time to the open forum.
Ah, sige po. Meron po dito, may nagtapasa na dito ng tanong, sabing ganyan, totoo, ito medyo sabi niya, totoo po ba na napaparalyze yung buong katawan ng mga bata sa sobrang paggamit ng bagets? Ito daw po yung mga nakikita nila sa Facebook, yung talagang yung mga nanginginig na nasusugod sa hospital. Totoo po ba ito, Doc?
This is from online news, you mean? From
yes po. Oo, yung sobrang paggamit daw po ng gadgets, paglalaro ng mga ML or ano pa man po tapos sa susunod.
Baka they have some neurological problem to begin with. Na trigger lang yon. I don't think the device itself or obvious triggers that, no? But if they're predisposed to a neurologic condition, yon baka, no? Nagkakaroon ng parang seizure effects.
Yes. So, yes, I believe na sagot ni Doc yun. So, we would like also to recognize po, Doc, yung mga nanonood sa Facebook at saka sa YouTube, no?
And to my students in San Beda, nanonood daw yung iba.
Hi po. Hi, hello. Good morning po sa mga taga San Beda. Welcome po sa Brigada Eskwela 2021 ng Eusebio High School. Ito po, may question po. Masama ba o nakakaapekto po ba sa mata ang pagtulog ng basa ang buhok? Pagbasa daw po ba yung buhok? Masama daw po ba ito? Nakakaapekto sa mata?
Hindi. So again, common myth. Na yan yung pinasa sa atin mga lola, mga magulang natin. No, not true.
Okay po. Gaano po ba katagal ipapahinga ang pagkatapos ng halos 3 oras na pagkatutok sa gadget ng mga bata ng mga bata at bago po uli sila magbasa?
Well, actually, you just have to rest. Yung nga, 20 minutes pa rin, no? Pero kung after 20 minutes, they can actually go back to the device, yung gadget, pwedeng balikan uli. Pero I think ang mas mahalaga dyan, kung madami na silang oras sa device, baka tama na for the day. Diba? Kasi kung naka 8 hours na sila, totoo, after 8 hours, pwede ka magpahinga na maybe 30 minutes, 20 minutes, tas balikan mo yung device. Kung kinakailangan, sige. Pero kung pwede naman ng huminto, wag na. Kasi yun, naka 8 hours ka na online. Ang tagal na nun. Kailangan na talaga magpahinga ng mata.
Okay. Salamat po. Doc, meron po dito sa chat back na nagtanong, good morning, Doc. I was diagnosed with facial, cellulitis. Connected po ba ito sa eyes? Kasi nag-start na po sa mata ko ang pamamaga.
Okay, who diagnosed the face? Kasi ganito yan. There is such a thing sa amin, no, in ophthalmology, preseptal cellulitis. So I don't know about facial cellulitis, if he's referring to the cheeks or the face, no. Pero sa amin, kung para sa mata, it is the eyelid. So pag eyelid ang namamaga, na mapula mo pala talaga and swollen, ang tawag namin diyan preseptal cellulitis. Or worse yet, kung pumasok na doon sa likod ng mata, orbital cellulitis. Yung orbital cellulitis at saka preseptal cellulitis requires antibiotic treatment. So I don't know, maybe I can ask the person, when he said facial cellulitis, some part ng mukha yun. Kasi ito yung buong face, saan dyan yung cellulitis?
Opo, saan po kaya si nagtanong po neto from MAPE Department? Ma'am Nancy, saan part daw po ng face yung pamamaga?
Ayan. Yes, pwede magsalita si Nancy.
Ma'am Nancy, if you're there po, Teacher Nancy, hello. Apo, siguro po while waiting kay Ma'am Nancy po, okay lang po the doc na meron pa po ditong
go ahead.
Apo, hindi ko na po ma-mention mga name, this one coming from YouTube, Facebook na mga questions, and isa po dito, gaano kapag may pinapatak po sa mata for dry eyes, ilang beses po dapat?
Okay. The normal recommendation is 1 drop 3 or 4 times a day. Like me, I don't have that much dry eyes now. I probably just use it twice a day. 3 to 4 is the usual. And then for some who really have severe dry eyes, some of them can use it every 2 to 3 hours. There is no overdose on lubricant drops. Again, these are lubricant drops. Sometimes, nagkakamali ang patient, hindi pala lubricant drop ang nagagamit, nagagamit nila steroid eye drop. Gaganda rin ang pakiramdam ng mata, but steroids is not good if it is overused. As I mentioned earlier, cataracts, glaucoma, mga side effects niyan. So, pero kung lubricant drop talaga siya, yan, wala naman talaga overuse yan. There was a time I was using it every 2 hours. It's okay.
Okay. Thank you po. Kapag may black clouds na nakikita po, ano ang ibig sabihin nito?
Black ba? Or black cloudy. Black, okay. Ayan. Yan nga yung sinasabi kong floater na parang may nakaharang sa mata. That person will probably need to see an eye doctor kasi we have to figure out what is the cause of the dark clouds, no? Or the floaters. We have to examine the eye well, yung tinatawag namin dilated eye exam. And probably advise the patient on what's the next step. Yung my question to that patient, if that patient is here, is or that person is here, diabetic ba siya? Kasi kung diabetic siya, pwedeng blood yun na nakaharang. Oo, yung clouds sa sinasabi niya. Yes, Ma'am Nancy. Look,
nandito na po si, apo, nandito na po si Ma'am Nancy. Go ahead, Ma'am.
Nakamute, Ma'am.
Okay, good morning, Doc.
Yes, Nancy, good morning. Po.
Last Tuesday po, nagpa-check up po ako sa opta kasi namaga yung mata ko.
Mm-hmm.
Then, nakita, ang sabi niya po is facial cellulitis kasi yung cheekbone ko po namamaga din.
Ah, okay. Yeah, okay. Opo.
Pero, ang billing niya po, if tomorrow hindi nag-subside yung pamamaga, kailangan ko daw po magpa-confine.
Nagbigay ba siya ng oral antibiotic?
Yes po.
Okay.
Saka po pampatak sa eye. Yeah. Kasi hindi po nag-subside yung pamamaga and then suddenly yesterday, maulan po, wala pong ophthalmologist sa halos lahat ng mga hospital na hinanapan okay. namin.
Anong antibiotic?
Daddy, anong pangalan ng antibiotic ko? Wait lang po, Doc. Co-amoxiclab po yung binigay niya.
Oh, that's very good. So, okay, hindi naman mawawala kagad yung pamamaga.
Apo.
Within 24 hours. I think what your doctor meant was kung lumala pa siya, then you need to be admitted. Eh, mukhang hindi naman lumala kasi nakakangiti ka pa eh.
Okay. And then, ano po, blind po yung tingin ko, malabo po yung right eye kung saan siya namamaga. Tapos parang nagkaroon po siya ng sugat dito sa gilid.
Yan. So baka meron kang infection eh. That's why you really need to continue the amoxiclab.
Yes.
As long as it is not getting worse, you need to complete the regimen. Yung ano yan, usually 7 days eh.
Apo.
Hindi po pwedeng 1 or 2 days lang yan. Hindi yan effective. You need
yes,
to complete 7 or maybe even 10 days. Ano yung dose mo ng amoxiclab? 1 gram?
Ilan ba to? 625 milligram po.
3 times a day?
Opo, every 8 hours.
Okay, oh, so that's good. Kasi either 625 every 8 hours or 1 gram or 1,000 gram milligrams every 12 hours. So yung dose mo is okay. Continue that and just observe, no? The medication should start to work and dapat after a few more days, nawawala na yung cellulitis mo, yung swelling. If talagang hindi nag-improve yan, I think you need to see an eye doctor na.
Okay po, Doc. Thank you po. Okay.
Thank you po, Ma'am Nancy. Doc, meron po ditong isa from our parent po.
Mm-hmm.
May nakikita daw po siyang rainbow sa gilid ng kanyang mata. Ano po ba ang pagka pinipikit niya to siguro or I don't know kung naka-open or pag pinipikit niya, ano daw po ba ang dapat gawin at ano daw po ang gamot dito?
Yung rainbow can also be a sign of dryness, no? So lubricate. But I would also suggest an eye exam kasi yung rainbow na yan can be also due to something else, no? I don't want to frighten naman the patient, no, by mentioning the disease that I'm thinking, but maganda ma-examine lang, no?
So baka dry lang.
Baka lang dry, no? But maganda pa rin ma-examine kasi there are other eye conditions that can also cause yung parang rainbow.
Sige po, Doc. Okay pa po ba?
Yeah,
okay lang
go
po.
Ahead,
may question
go ahead.
Pa. Thank
go
you so ahead. Much. Paano nadidevelop ang eye bag? Paano po ito matatanggal?
Eye bag?
Opo.
Okay. Yung eye bag is due to the sagging of the eyelid, no? Nagsasag yan because of age. Parang yung ako, yung chan ko, yung bilbil ko, di ba? Because of age, nagsasag na yan, no? And right behind the eyelid, lahat tayo, even kids, when we're born, right behind the eyelid is what we call fat tissue. May taba talaga yan. Nakatago lang yan doon kasi doon nakapatong yung eyeball. Okay? It helps support the eyeball para makagalaw yung eyeball. That fat should be behind the eyelid. Kaya lang, pag nagsasag na yung eyelid, tumutulak na yung fat. Kaya nagkakaroon ng eye bag. No? Some individuals or some people talagang mabilis magsag yung skin. Ayun, eye bag. Paano mapipigilan? There's really no way to prevent aging, so you cannot also prevent that. Siguro, my advice lang, at this point kasi too late na, but for the younger people in our group, maybe don't rub your eyes too much, 'di ba? Yung ibang grabe makakusot ng mata, manghihina yung eye, baka magsag yan pagtanda mo, okay? Some say using a cold compress helps, no? It shrinks some of the tissue para nababawasan ng konti yung eye bag. But really, once the eye bag is severe, of course, it's just a cosmetic problem. Di naman talaga nakakasama sa paningin yan. Pero yung iba, kung gustong gawa ng paraan, that requires cosmetic surgery or eyelid surgery. Itatighten namin naman, yung eyelid.
Usually talaga nakikita natin yung eye bag sa mga matatanda na.
Yes.
Ito, Doc, masama daw bang maligo after magbabad sa gadgets? Ayan, baka meets ko ba yan?
Okay, yung sinasabi nilang napapasma, hindi rin naman Opo. Totoo yun. In fact, putting a cold compress sometimes helps with the swelling and also helps with the, it gives some relief, di ba? Kasi parang nire-relax mo siya. So taking a bath, no effect, no problem with that.
Should I go ahead pa po, Doc?
Yeah, tuloy lang. Sige.
Pag sumakit po ba ang ulo pati mata ay dahilan po ba sa reading glass na ginagamit po, Doc? Sabi po ng ating mga audience.
Okay, my question there is, yung sakit ng ulo ba nangyayari pag nagbabasa? If so, then yes, maybe hindi na tama yung sukat ng reading glass or baka masyado lang sobrang daming binabasa, napapagod na rin. However, if there is headache, even if you're not reading, no, then that might be something else. If there is eye pain, kahit na hindi ka naman nagbasa, tapos masakit na yung mata mo, baka something else is going on. Yun yung kailangan na natin patignan yung mata. Kasi yung mga glaucoma, ganon. Pero pag related sa reading and only during times that you are reading na sumasakit, it's possible na mali yung sukat ng grado ng salamin.
Totoo yan. Ako rin nakasalamin. Minsan check natin. Doc, sabi po ni Mark Christopher Nilo, "Hi Doc, are there studies that relate vision complication with COVID-19?
Yes. In fact, I just posted it on my Facebook page. But the COVID-19 can present as sore eyes. Mm-hmm. So if you have symptoms of sore eyes, kaya kami sa clinic namin, ingat na ingat kami pag may pasyenteng parang sore eyes yung symptoms, no? Kasi baka it can present, COVID can present that way. Why? COVID-19 is a virus. Sore eyes is actually also a virus. Yung dating alam nating sore eyes is because of a virus of the surface of the eye. So actually, that's why COVID-19 being a virus can also present with sore eyes or conjunctivitis. Namumula yung mata, nagluluha. So when that happens, observe. Try to see an eye doctor. If there is concomitant o may kasabay na lagnat and other symptoms, baka COVID. So, yan yung kailangan in quarantine and possibly magpa-test. No?
Okay po. Dok, yung pangingitim daw po around the eyes from sugarabot, ask ko po yung pangingitim around the eyes po.
Pangingitim yung eyelid o yung pangingitim doon sa puti ng mata?
Hindi naka-specific eh.
So, di ba yung mata natin merong cornea, yung brown or black part sa gitna, di ba, na bilog. And then the sides is white, no? So, kung sinasabi niya yung white na nangingitim, well, we need to check, no? It could be pigmentation only. So, may mga tinatawag kaming conjunctival nevus or conjunctival pigmentation. Usually benign naman yon, but kailangan matingnan din kasi merong isang sakit na nangingitim yung puti ng mata, yung pala melanoma, no? Or pwede rin nangingitim yung itim ng mata, yung puti ng mata nangingitim, pwede rin kasi siyang scleritis, no? So kailangan balikan ko lang po.
Balikan ko lang po yung kanina nung sa COVID-19, so yung psoriasis maaring na tawag nito.
Presenting symptom ng COVID-19, yes.
Kaya talaga sa mga estudyanteng nanonood ngayon, importante yung paghuhugas ng kamay. Ano po? Kaya ingatan natin o huwag na talagang hawak kung saan-saan. Tapos ikakamutin natin yung ating mga mata. Ayan po ay observation ng ating mga teachers. Na yan sila Ma'am Luisa. Okay, may tanong pa po dito. Ang sabi po, okay pa po, Doc?
Okay lang.
All right, sabihin nyo lang po, Doc. Ha? Sabihin
nyo
lang po.
It's okay, go ahead. Teams,
may mga team naman po na nagsasabi. Good day po, Doc. Present po ay parang may buhangin ang aking nararamdaman. Medyo luha dry sa eyes. Dry eyes. Okay.
Buhangin, tapos nagluluha. Dry eyes. Lubricate, dry lubricant drops. Yes.
Mm-hmm. So like what you said po kanina, any lubricants can do ano?
Yeah. The more popular ones, you have Systane, Cellulvis, Optive, Hyalid, Hyabac. Yan.
Yan po. Good morning everyone and always stay safe, doctors from San Beda University. Binasa ko lang po. Hi po sa mga doctors at mga estudyante po ni Dr. San Beda University. Ayan. Meron pa po dito. Sabi po, yung nahihilo daw po pagtayo. Ayan. After ng ilang oras na nakatutok sa gadgets, ano daw po kaya yun po?
Well, if you're actually kahit di ka nakatutok sa gadget, if you're seated for a long time, pwede ka talagang mahilo pag bigla kang tumayo. It's similar to what we call orthostatic hypotension. Magbibigla, pwede kasi biglang mag-change yung blood pressure mo, mag-drop kasi nag-change, sudden change in position ka. That's why nga sinasabi nga namin importante na don't stay seated too long, no? Importante talaga na tumatayo. Secondly, huwag ka rin bigla kasi tatayo, no? Pwede ka talaga mahilo noon. So, if that's happening, you might want to be sure na you don't fall down, to grab onto something as you're standing up, no? Usually not a problem in younger individuals, pero in older individuals, older patients, yan, they are prone to orthostatic hypotension. Yung biglang tumayo sila kasi.
Opo. All right, sabi dito, yeah, over the counter po ang lubricant na mention po ni Doc hanggang ilang oras. Bali, ni-screen ko rin lang po kasi yung iba medyo nasagot na. Meron po dito, nilodo po tayo. Okay. So, yung pwede nyo po, for instance, may mga teachers po tayo dito na mayroong matanong. You can unmute your phone po para po ma-direct natin diretso kay Doc ang ating mga tanong while I'm scanning the questions here sa chat box. Parang nanginiit po ang paligid ng... Hi po, Doc. Paano po pag parang nagiinit yung gilagid daw po ng eyes niya?
Nagiinit yung eyelids?
Yung paligid.
Well, it could also still be dry eyes. Baka dry ano eyes. Lang. Or pagod yung mata. No? Kaya nga, sometimes cold compress works. No? Ano lang yan eh? Sign of... overuse. So you can lubricate, no? You can lubricate, no? And do a cold compress. So yung cold compress simple lang. Alam ko may nabibili na ng mga parang eye mask shape na mga gel na pwede mo lang ilagay sa ref, no? Or you can just grab a plastic bag, put a few pieces of ice cubes, no, from the freezer, tapos ilagay niyo sa plastic bag, sandwich bag, wrap it in the towel, tapos ilagay niyo lang over the eyes para lang mag-cool down.
Doc, si Ma'am Marie Chris Pereira. Ma'am Marie Chris Pereira, may tanong po kayo. You can unmute po, di ba? Ma'am Marie Chris. Hello, Ma'am Marie Chris. Doc, yes, ayan pa. Good morning.
Yeah, hello.
Yes, good morning po, Doc. Ang eyes ko po kasi madalas po magkaroon ng parang white thread like na mahapdi po sa mata.
Dry eyes.
Dry eyes po yun.
Oh, di yung sa slide ko kanina, sabi ko parang may sipon na puti.
So, hindi po kasi siya yung parang sipon na malambot po. Para sa talagang kapag hinila mo, mahaba.
Yes. Oh. Yun yung kasi yung lubric, yung tears natin nandiyan sa mata. Tapos syempre may mga iba pang substances sa surface. But pag yan natuyo, pwede siya mag-form talaga ng mga string-like discharge. So, umisan parang sipon. Pero pag lalo pa siya natuyo, para na siyang thread.
Opo.
Oo. It's still probably dry ice, lalo na sabi mo parang mahapdi. Then the two of those are symptoms of dry eyes. So I would suggest try out first a lubricant eye drop. No, if it improves, then just maintain the lubricant eye drops. If it's not working, we may need to see it. Baka mamaya meron na talaga palang infection sa eyelashes, sa eyelid.
Okay po. Thank you, Doc.
Salamat po. Siguro mga ilang tanong na lang tayo. Ito po. Good AM po, Doc. Okay lang po ba yung ang paggamit ng pipino na ipinapatong sa mata para ma-relax kaysa gumamit ng eye drops?
Okay. Yung pipino na yan, it's really the cold temperature that helps relieve the eye. So it helps relieve the swelling of the eyelid, no? When you relieve the swelling kasi, you also somehow improve the lubrication. Pero kung talagang dry eyes ka kasi, you may still need to use the lubricant drops. Eh, there's no harm in doing that, no? Yung sinasabi lang pipino. Actually, ice nga pwede lang eh. But alam ko, kahit yung mga tita ko noon, mahilig din sa pipinong cold, no, na nilalagay sa eyelid. So it's really the temperature that does the work, not the pipino.
Pwede po ba, di ba, after mag-ilagay yung pipino, kainin? Pag na-expose
kung malinis yung eyelid mo, yes. Kung malinis yung eyes mo, pwede.
So, a simple exercise po for the eyes, like yung mga pwede namin kaagad tandaan while kasi kami mga teachers na talaga nakatutok sa laptop, sa gadgets po namin. Simple exercise po that can do to relax easily po yung rejuvenate
kagad yung ano. The advice we gave earlier, which is 20-20-20, when yung last part on which is looking at something 20 feet away, yun na yung eye exercise kasi you're looking away, no? So yung looking away is the exercise that needs to be done. Mm-hmm. So aside from limiting for 20 minutes and take a 20 second break, the exercise part of that advice is the one where you look at something 20 feet away. What happens there is your muscles inside the eye magre-relax. So yun na yun. Some would say, look to the left, right, look up, look down. Hindi naman na kailangan yun. I think just looking away for 20 minutes. Looking away at 20 after, feet after 20 minutes of computer work is enough. No? Or close your eyes. That's another thing you can do also. Para ma-recoat yung surface ng mata.
Alright. Thank you so much for that, Doc. Last question po from Ma'am Louie. Pwede din kaya yung may allergic rhinitis lubricant? Kasi yes. Doc, minsan...
Sorry, I cut you off on your question.
Okay na po.
So, sabi allergic rhinitis... ano sabi niya?
Minsan daw po, minsan may redness din ako na parang may sipon. Minsan sa left, minsan sa right.
Yes. Few questions. If she has allergic rhinitis, she's probably using antihistamines, oral, no? Very common yan sa mga allergic rhinitis, binibigyan sila ng anti-allergy medication.
And
those anti-allergy medications can also cause some amount of dryness of the surface of the eye. So, yes, lubricants will be useful, no? Kung hindi naman nangangati yung mata at medyo dry lang yung pakiramdam or you have the symptoms of dryness as I mentioned earlier, then yes, you can just use the lubricants. Kung nangangati yung mata, yan, that is where we may need to use anti-allergy eye drops. No? Also, a word of advice to her, I'm not sure if she's using nasal steroids. No, it's very common for the ENT and the allergy specialist to prescribe oral and nasal steroids for allergic rhinitis. That is okay. That is safe. But it will also be good to monitor the eye, have an eye checkup na rin. Kasi nga, with the use of steroids, no, kahit na nasal lang yan or oral, it can potentially lead to some eye diseases like cataract and glaucoma. I'm not saying don't use the steroids. They're very helpful. No, I also use nasal steroids sometimes. No, kasi I also have rhinitis. No, what's important is siguro get an eye checkup kahit once, no, just to make sure na walang ibang problema sa mata.
Okay. So we are now done with one last question, I think. Hello, Doc. Ask ko lang po, ano po ang ibig sabihin kapag may lumalabas na red sa ugat sa may mata? Hindi na po kasi siya naaalis. Okay. Red na ugat daw po.
Yes. yung puti ng mata natin, tinatawag nating sclera, actually, if you look closely, and kami, nakikita namin talaga yan when we see the patients in the clinic, meron talaga maugat dyan. No? Hindi naman siya talaga puti. Actually, pag tinignan mo, puti siya, tapos marami siyang ugat. No? Maliliit lang yung ugat. They're so small that you don't see them with the normal human eye. No? You need a microscope to see them well. However, in some patients, no, namamaga o nagsiswell yung vessels. No? Pag namamaga na yan, yan, mas pansin ng tao. Kaya yun yung ugat na sinasabi siguro ng patient. Now, we have to examine the patient kasi we need to find out how big that vessel is. Madami ba talaga? Kasi there are some conditions, no, or diseases that causes swelling of those vessels, no. Some of them, there is what we call scleritis, no, namamaga yung blood vessels ng sclera. Episcleritis, common in females. And then yung mga worst case scenarios, yung mga may fistula, no. But the only way we can determine if it is something serious is to have the eye examined, no. Sometimes namumula lang yung pag namumula yung mata natin, actually yung normal redness of the eye, yun yung blood vessels talaga ng puti ng mata na medyo inflamed, namamaga, kaya napapansin. And then pag nag-recover na halimbawa yung sore eyes or yung dryness, bumabalik na siya doon sa normal size niya na hindi na napapansin. Pero pag medyo persistent, yung kagaya na sinasabi nung nagtanong na parang nandun na hindi nawawala, baka kailangan ma-examine na yon. Baka may nangyayaring something else.
Okay. Doc, last na lang po talaga.
Hindi, sige lang. We have time.
Doc, do you have free consultation platform like sa online po or either in hospital?
Online consultation?
Apa, may mga ganun daw po ba kayo na, you know?
Yeah. I have a online consultation. It's through SiriusMD. I have a Facebook page, you know, Fernandino Fontanilla, where I sometimes share information about eye conditions and how to prevent the eye. My clinics are in Medical City in Pasig. I think your school is based in Pasig.
Yes po, in actually malapit lang siya, one ride from Medical City. So, kasi po doc, ito pa yung question ng ating mga magulang, you know, we are in the public school po, sana sabi na baka may mga free consultation na ginagawa si doc kahit online or what.
Yeah, walang problema. Like, this is we're doing it now, di ba?
Yeah, actually po. You're giving us so much information already.
So, yeah, I mean if you visit the Facebook page, no, if you have concerns, no, you can send a message there and I will try to reply and answer.
Okay. All right. Ayan. So Dr. Fontanilla, maraming salamat po sa inyong time at sa mga advices na inyo pong ipinagkaloob sa amin, lalo-lalo na po sa mga mag-aaral ng Eusebio High School.
May I also add lang, For consultations pala, because I am I'm with the San Beda College of Medicine, we actually have an online teleconsultation. Ano yun rin? Free rin yun. So our clerks, no, together with kami mga consultants, we can. I just have to check the schedule on that, no, but I know we are launching, if we haven't launched yet, the teleconsultation to include hopefully ophthalmology. So, pwede naman tayong mag free consultation using our San Beda telemedicine platform. So, I'll get you more info on that. Let me check first if it's already been up and running. Through my student na lang si Clerk Niegas, no? I-coordinate sa inyo para we can share that information for you.
All right. So we're so excited, Doc, na ang San Beda Telemedicine platform will be our partners in Brigada Escuela 2021. With that, Doc, maraming salamat po uli sa time, sa mga advices, sa mga information po na binigay nyo sa buong paaralan ng Eusebio High
School.
At this point, we would like to give you a certificate of appreciation. And let me read the citation. Okay po, while we're waiting po, we would like also to thank kay Dr. Francis Niegas.
Yes.
Opo, thank you so much po sa pagkakataon na ipinagkaloob nyo po sa Brigada Eskwela ng UCEBU High School. Brigada Eskwela 21, this certificate of recognition is awarded to Fernandino Jose A. Fontanilla, MD, for his participation as a resource speaker in the Brigada Eskwela webinar 2021, taking care of the eyes on September 9, 2021. Given this 9th of September 2021 at the UCEBU High School, Rosario, Pasig City. Signed by Gemma L. Rubilos, Brigada Eskwela Coordinator, and Annaline M. Makasinag, our principal to UCEBU High School. Let's give Dr. Fontanilla a big round of applause.
Yes. Thank you very much for inviting me. It was a pleasure to see you all, kahit online, and to talk to you about the eye.
Thank you so much. Maraming salamat po, Doc. At ingat po kay lagi. And again,
ingat din,
grateful po kami to have you in our Brigada Eskwela.
Get your vaccinations.
Thank you.
If there are people who are having problems with vaccination, I just got word that the one in Nayong Pilipino, they are really doing mass vaccination up to 15,000 a day. You just have to register. So for those of you na nahirapan makakuha ng vaccine, I think that's one of the options for you. Yun lang.
Doc, sandali lang po siguro because everybody is requesting to have a picture with you. And okay. Siguro po, siguro mga sandali lang po ito.
Yeah, yeah.
It's our time to take pictures with us. Kasama si Dr. Fontanilla. Before I go to the next part pa. Ayan. Alright, I think we are through. Okay, again, let's give Dr. Fontanilla a big virtual round of applause.
Ayan. Thank you very much.
Thank you po.
Thank you po, Doc.
Thank you, Doc. Thank you po.
Yes, thank you. And thank you also sa lahat ng mga magulang at mga thank bata na rin dyan. Thank you.
Thank you po. Right, sa mga teacher po.
Thank you po, Doc.
Unmute for Nacho Jan.
Thank you po. Thank you po.
Thank you po.
Thank you po.
Thank you po,
Doc.
Once again, may call on Ma'am Beraline M. De La Cruz, our chairman and program implementation of Brigada Eskwela 2021 for the closing remarks. Ma'am Beraline? Hello? Ayan. So again po, we're not yet done. Please okay, stay. Ayan. Go ahead, Ma'am Beraline.
Isang mapagpalang umaga po sa ating lahat, sa aming mga magulang na nakasama namin sa umaging ito, sa mga mag-aaral, sa ating punong guro, Ma'am Annaline M. Makasinag, sa ating ASTP ng Junior High School, Ma'am Ninita Viranyon, sa Rapi D. Maga, assistant ng Senior High School, assistant to the principal ng Senior High School, mga puno ng kagawaran, mga dalugguro, at aking kapwa-guro, isang ligtas na umaga po sa ating lahat. According to Mahatma Gandhi, it is health that is real wealth and not pieces of gold and silver. Totoo po na napakahalaga ng may maayos na kalusugan kaysa sa anumang bagay sa mundong ito. Napakaganda ng topic natin na nagpapaalala sa atin na dapat nating alagaan ang ating mga mata. Gayun din, isang seryosong kalagayan na huwag nating ibaliwala. Kaya maraming salamat po, Dr. Fernandino Jose Fontanilla, sa mga mahalagang bagay, tips na itinuro niyo po sa amin na dapat naming alagaan ang aming mga mata at iwasan ang mga bagay na nakasasama dito. Isang babala sa amin na dapat ingatan at protektahan ang aming mga mata. Salamat pong muli, Dr. Fontanilla. Gayun din mga magulang at mga mag-aaral. Ituon natin ang ating mga paningin sa kabutihan ng Panginoon at tignan ang mga magagandang nilikha ng Diyos. On behalf of Ma'am Mildred D. Manubag, God bless and take care of our eyes. Maraming salamat po.
Yes, thank you so much, Ma'am Beraline, for that closing remarks. So pangalagaan natin ang ating mga mata sapagkat ito ay mahalaga sa pag-aaral ngayong pandemya. Mula sa bumubuo ng Brigada Eskwela 2021, kami ay lubos na nagpapasalamat sa lahat ng mga dumalo at nakalahok sa webinar na ito, sa ating po mga bisita, sa mga bata, sa mga estudyante, sa mga magulang at sa lahat po ng teacher na nakiisa. Maraming salamat po. So announcement lang po, attendance for this webinar 3 has been sent to the different GC and to the teachers and students. Please see to it na nakapag-attendance din kayo and please submit it to your sa inyong mga advisor. So meron po tayong photo off. Please open your camera now. Ayan, thank you so much. Ayan, so please open your camera now for the photo of. Ayan, maraming salamat sa mga estudyante namin at sa mga magulang.
Smile po, parents and students. Shout po tayo.
Smile po tayo.
Smile po lahat ng magulang at mga mag-aral.
So meron tayong 15 na no, no slide. So nasa 1 muna tayo.
Next slide.
Sino po yung kumukuha, ma'am? Oh, next slide na po. Smile lang po tayo.
Smile lang po. Parents, students, smile lang po tayo for picture taking. Teachers. Okay, slide 5. 15 slide po ito. Tease lang ng konti. Smile po. 11 slide na tayo. And last. Thank you very much po, dear
there
parents.
There you go. Yay. Thank you so much muli. Pangalagaan natin ang ating mga mata sapagkat ito'y mahalaga sa pag-aaral ngayong pandemya at sa mga susunod pa. Thank you po and God bless. So panatili po tayong mag-ingat. Stay distance. Mag-distance tayo.